If you write tests using Swift testing, I'm sure that you've written this kind of code before. You use the @test annotation to write an accurate description of your test, but you also have to provide a function name because Swift requires you to do it. And very often, this function name ends up being an abridged version of the description of the test. That's not great by any means, and it would be really nice if we could avoid having to provide this superfluous function name. The good news is that since Swift 6.2, this has become possible. Indeed, Swift 6.2 now supports using raw identifiers for function names, which allows us to directly use the description of the test as the function name. This way, we now have much more freedom on which characters we can use in the function name. We can of course use white spaces, but we can also start the identifier with a digit or use an operator inside the identifier. So if you're using Swift testing, you might want to consider starting to use this new syntax because it will make writing your tests a smoother experience. That's all for this video. I hope that you've enjoyed discovering this new feature of Swift 6.2. As always, if you've enjoyed the video, don't forget to like it and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss the next ones. Thank you for watching and see you next time.